I would like to demonstrate to you how to add rules to your model, basically to a field. Adding rules to a field uses your custom rules to test the value before actually, you know, submitting it to the database. So this is a quite good feature to actually have in your component. Now I'm just going to use this Hello World component, the one we actually did a Hello World tutorial on, and I'm going to add a rule to one of its fields and then quickly type it up and show you how to include it. Okay, so I've gone to admin views. I'm going to open this greeting first as the admin view. We want to change the field in it. I think let's use this greetings, and let's add a rule that we can call something like, and we see at this time that the field attributes don't have the validation option switch in place. So we might start shipping JCB with this new validation property. Well, it's not new, it's just not been added yet. But if you have a version of JCB that doesn't have it set, then whatever field type you've selected, you can edit the field type going here, or you could edit the field type by going to field types. So just have to close out of this again, and then here field types, and you can select the field type that you want to add this validation to. We want to do it for now just to the text area, so it's this one. And it has a filter in place. I think I'm going to add validation just underneath it, so just going to click here plus. It is adjustable, it's not required, it's not translatable, and let's give it a little description. Okay, so I think we've got it all set. We don't add a value here because if you don't want to use it, you just leave it empty. And okay, that's basically it. Save and close. So we've done the text area. Now let's go back to our admin view, greetings, and again open that field. And now we have this validate property available to us. So we can now copy it and add it in here. Now we want to have a custom validation here. There are built-in Joomla validations as well, but you can also set up a custom validation rule, and this is what or form rule as it's known. This is what we want to demonstrate. So we're gonna say let's call our rule stir len 10. So my string must be longer than 10 characters. Okay, I think that should do. So I'm just gonna copy this again and save and close. So now that we've got our validation set, JCB is not yet able to, well, we don't have an area for you to write the rule and have it be included. So the way you do this, and I think it's efficient, is that you write up the file yourself, you put it in the custom folder of JCB, and you include it into the component so that it places it in the correct place. You see, the one thing that JCB already does for you is that it creates a folder called rules, and in the forms, every XML, if we open it, it already has a field path and a rule path. So you can just add your rule to this, basically to this folder, which I will demonstrate to you in a moment. But first, let's create our rule. So I added this rule here. So in the folder structure, I'm basically in the admin area, components, component builder, and there's this folder called custom. And inside of this folder, I've now created this stirlen10 file, and in it I've placed this this code here, basic JForm rule, nothing too fancy about it. Okay, let's see. Now that we've got our file in place, we need to add it into our component. So we go to the components and we open that component. And we go to settings, and here adding custom files and folders. We click on this component files and folders, create component files and folders for this Joomla component. And we just click on that, say okay. And here we want to add one file. Since we've added it to that custom folder, everything in that custom folder will come up as a file that you can select. So there it is, that file. Now the path to where we want it to place the file. So in the backend of the component, we go to models, forms, and we are targeting this greeting form. So we open that and we see that it has models rules. So let's copy that. Now we need to remember that it is admin, the admin area, and then models rules. So this admin is basically the way the package is built, so the target place should be the place inside the package. This be always the case for both folders and fields. So in the folder, you want it to add it to the admin models rules folder, and then you need to decide whether you want this file to be updated. Now, at this stage, that file doesn't need any updating. But hey, we can change that. So you can see I've just added this new license tag to it. And I've added this bomb. Basically, when the file gets taken, it will take this part away and replace this with your component's license. And so the file will basically become branded like every other file in your component. And even if you use it in areas or components other than the one you originally made it for, it'll just dynamically look like it was made for it, because it will add that component's data at the header of the file. And even if you add the component's name somewhere else in this, you can actually replace it with the well-known ##, component ##, and it will replace it with a component name. Okay, enough of that. We've got our file in place, we want it to be updated, and now let's compile the component and see it in action. So here, just tick this as yes, the file should be updated, and then save and close. Also close out of the component again. There's now a shortcut to that file area over here that you can use. We go to the compiler and we compile our component. Okay, it's done. Now let's install our component. Now let's go look at the code to see what happened. Okay, so here's our component's admin area. If we open rules, we see, ha, there's our file. It was placed into the rule folder. If we open that file, we say, ha, it added our copy notice to the header of the file. And now let's also look at our XML. We scroll down. We see the validation is there, stirlen.10. So everything so far so good. Now let's go test this. So we open this component in the backend. We go to greetings, We click new. Now, as you remember, we said that greetings now needs to have a length of at least 10 characters. So let's test this. So we add greeting, which isn't enough, and we click save. And it tells us invalid field, greetings. Oh, problem. There's one little change I had to make to get this to work, and I realize I'll need to tell you. Okay, let's go look at this. For some reason, they want this file all lowercase, so I had to change strlen to the T also lower. So let's go do this also with the file in our custom folder. And then inside of the actual file, they also want the T here to be lowercase. I suppose because they are using the uppercase camel rule to sort of break up the name. Let's see. Okay, so that was what I had to do to get it to work. Now, I also need to just update the component to include this file. Since the name is changed, it will no longer know where it is. So we open the component. Well, you know what? Let's not open the component. Let's go directly to that file area with a shortcut. And we see it's no longer selected, so we scroll down, select it again, and save and close. That should do it. Okay, so now that we've fixed the little glitch which I created myself, let's go back to see this again in action. And save. And invalid field, greetings. Okay, that isn't very helpful. Maybe you would like to also show a custom message, so that the user will at least know more about what is going on here. But now, before we do that, let's add enough values and see that it actually saves. And now it's saved successfully. Close. So our greeting has been saved and our value here is more than 10 characters, so it was valid. Now, let's go add a custom message to our validation. Now remember, whatever you do to the live version of this file will not necessarily become part of the next compilation. So adding a custom message, you need to actually go back to component builder custom and to that actual file and add it in there, then recompile your component and it will automatically update the live demonstration. So the other way, just to test before doing it live, or you know, before adding it to the core of your component, it's to actually go to the live file, which as we saw is here in Hello World, models, rules, strlen 10. Good. Now let's add our custom message in here just to test. Okay, we're using the element and adding an attribute to the element. Message, field must have more than 10 characters. That is one way of doing this, of course. There is another way. Again, this takes us back to JCB, and we go to the field. We open greetings. And we look for the attribute message. Ah, it doesn't have message. So we need to add this attribute. We click on field type. And we scroll down. I think let's place this under description. So we say message. It's changeable. It is translatable. And it's optional, so we don't make it compulsory. Okay, we got all set. So just save and close. Now, let's add this validation, sorry, the message to our field. Now, before we save this and actually go this path, let's first test our live change we made to the file and see if that also works. So, in the file, we added this attribute to the element. and basically returned false. Good, now let's go test this. So we again open that item and we take away a few characters and click save. And there we get our message that it needs more than 10 characters. Okay, great, so that option also works very well. Now let's use the other one, which I suppose is more convenient. Unless you are checking multiple things and you would like to give multiple error messages based on those results, then this implementation is the better option. But if you just got one message and it just needs to really explain to the user one issue, then using the XML path, I suppose, is more convenient. So in our custom file, we haven't added that change. So let's go and compile our component and install. First, we need to save and close out of this field so that the changes be captured. Then go to the compiler and compile our component. Install. Let's go look at the code. So here in the code, we see our custom message is again not showing up. In the XML greeting, we now have this translated message here, as you can see. Now let's go test this. So again, we open that field. And first, let's just save it the way it is. Okay, good, it works. Let's take away two characters and save again. And we get the expected message. This time around, that message can be translated, and as well, it is actually in the XML file. It's not part of the actual function. Okay, well, so I think this covers it. We have now successfully added our own validation rule to one field within a view, and we were able to include that rule into our component on compilation by using adding custom files. Thank you for watching.